Hampton, Dellinger is live outside the courthouse in Greensboro with some perspective. Hampton, we understand that the jury came back into the courtroom to ask a question. What possibly could they have questions about at this point?
We don't know yet. The question has not been made public. They passed a note to the judge. They could have questions, though, about a lot of things. This is, of course, a first-of-its-kind case, whether money to a mistress to cover up an affair should be considered an illegal campaign contribution. There are six felony counts. The conspiracy counts has four questions underneath it. So this is not an easy case for the jury. They got 50 pages worth of jury instructions. We don't know what's on their mind, but it could be one of many things.
Surprised that a verdict has not come back already at this point. I know they just started the deliberations, but I know that there are some people who thought it would be down and dirty.
I would be surprised if a guilty verdict came back quickly. The jury saw a packed courtroom, saw cameras from across the country for more than a month. They know that at least most of the country is paying attention to their work. The case is now fully on their shoulders, and I think a rush to judgment is not what they want to have the appearance be. So maybe a not guilty verdict quickly. I think a guilty verdict, particularly given the number of questions they have to go through, could take us a day or two.
And is it likely that the jury might be grappling with the idea of, on one hand, if, you know, John Edwards is whether or not he's a good guy or not, which is not a crime, versus, you know, has he committed one?
Yes and no. I mean, I hope that they are not putting their personal feelings towards him as a husband, as a candidate who lied to his supporters, you know, front and center. There are so many difficult legal issues for them to grapple with. Of course, the judge worked so hard to get a fair and impartial group of 12, starting with a pool of over 200 men and women from the triad. You know, we do know with the dismissal of the alternates that the jury is now 8 men, 4 women. So it's more men than the broader group of 12 plus the four alternates. Some people speculated Don Edwards wanted a jury of as many men as possible who might sympathize with his desire to keep the affair quiet from his wife.
Do you think we'll get a verdict today?
I would still be surprised if we got a guilty verdict. Of course, only those in the room know for sure where they are. They've been at it for about 2.5 hours now. But again, I think a quick guilty verdict would be surprising given, you know, the complexity of the case, the six counts, the multiple questions. I think a guilty verdict is something we're more likely to see next week.
All right. Hampton Dellinger, thank you so much. We appreciate it.